Yo dudes, it is Blake from Green Knuckles Across, and as you can tell by the title of this video, we are going to be using fishing line as sidewall string. This idea came to mind when a lot of people have been telling me that they actually don't prefer the way that I string my face-off heads, and as they keep the knots to the outside, because it wears down the mesh, and yes, over time, it will wear down the mesh. But the benefit of stringing the knots to the outside of the head is to prevent the ball from getting stuck in the back of the stick. So instead of changing the type of mesh we use based off of how thick it is, or the type of sidewall stringing pattern we're going to use, I figured we might as well just change the sidewall string itself. And we all know that once the knots start to slip towards the inside of the head, it's pretty much game over from there when getting the ball out of the back of the stick. So I started thinking to myself, what is a really thin material that is decently strong and can be used as a substitute for normal sidewall string? My first initial instinct was to try fishing line. Now, I went out to Walmart and got this 250-yard spool of fishing line. It's 30-pound monofilament made by OmniFlex. And for those who don't really know a lot about fishing, there are three main kinds of fishing line. There's monofilament like this, there's braid, and there's fluorocarbon. And of all three of those fishing lines, the monofilament helps the most with abrasion, which we do see a lot as face-off guys. Next thing I did was I cut two pieces off of this spool about the same length as a normal sidewall string that you would get in a stringing kit. And I went ahead and strung up this STX dual. Both sides have the fishing line in it. And as you can see, this is just a normal stringing pattern that you'll see on any other head. No crazy knots, no knots to the outside, nothing. I didn't want to provide a handicap for the fishing line. I wanted to actually make sure that this stuff can withstand true face-offs and to see if you can actually use it in games. The pocket turned out real nice, a lot better than what I expected. When I keep pushing it back and forth, you can just see how the knots lay in the back of the head real nice and flush to the plastic. Nothing crazy sticking off. You can just see how flat that mesh lays to the head. Now the great thing about this, it's one less thing to worry about if you are experiencing the ball getting stuck in the back of the head. Usually it's one, your head's too pinched, two, your mesh is too thick, or three, your sidewall knots are inside the head and it's causing the ball to get stuck. So now we just eliminate that last one where the sidewall knots are pushed inside. Now you're focused on two things rather than three, which is a plus. So right out of the gates, we eliminated one problem with using fishing line over sidewall string, and that is it lessens the chance of the ball getting stuck in the back of the head because it's literally just the plastic and the mesh. There's no extra bulk from knots at all. So the next thing to do was to test and see how strong the fishing line actually is. And the best way of doing that is with live reps. So we did 50 dummy stick reps and 50 live reps. But unfortunately, we weren't able to capture all 50 live reps, but we still had enough footage from both sessions, so check it out. And after 100 reps of using fishing line as our sidewall string, there were no breaks, no scratches, no fraying, nothing to any part of the fishing line on the head whatsoever. I was extremely impressed with how this stuff held up. I thought it was for sure gonna break after the 5th or 10th rep, but it stayed strong, it did its job, and I am ultimately satisfied with how it turned out. Now, I'm not exactly sure how well this fishing line is going to hold up down the road. I've only taken 100 reps with it, but based off of the 100 reps, it's been doing phenomenal. And I will continue to take reps with this, and if anything happens, I will keep you guys updated on my Instagram. Overall, I was extremely impressed how this turned out. I thought it was gonna be a huge flunk after the first 10 reps, but it stayed strong, it did its job, and I would definitely recommend trying fishing line as your sidewall string for your face-off heads. Worst case scenario, fishing line breaks, and you waste $2. So I would definitely recommend trying it out. And that wraps up this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys want to see more videos like this where I take random stuff, use it as sidewall string for my face-off heads, and see if it actually works for face-offs, let me know down in the comment section below. Like and share this video, subscribe to our channel, and if you haven't already, check us out on Instagram at GreenKnucklesLacrosse, and check out our sweet hats available at GreenKnucklesLacrosse.com. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Till then, kids, get them dirty.